What you are looking at is a strange and alien-looking landscape in the American Southwest. Here, numerous remnants of dinosaurs long extinct can be found, along with petrified trees raised off of the ground in strange positions and highly unusual-looking rock units. And, quite importantly, this area contains the remnants of one of Earth's largest cataclysms which caused the extinction of the non-avian dinosaurs. This mass extinction occurred due to the impact of a 19-kilometer-wide asteroid off of the northern coast of the Yucatan Peninsula 66.04 million years ago, releasing energy equivalent to the detonation of 100 million megatons of TNT. This created a devastating impact winner, and ejecta left behind from this catastrophic event created a white layer surrounded by black coal, which is today referred to as the KPG, or Cretaceous Paleogene Boundary, as shown in this rock. This is the story of New Mexico's Bisti Wilderness and how this geologic oddity formed. The Bisti Wilderness can be found in the northwest quadrant of New Mexico, where it is 30 miles south of the city of Farmington and encompasses an area of approximately 70 square miles. The most famous feature of the Bisti Wilderness are the very thin white chimneys that seemingly have darker colored rocks placed precariously on top of them. These features are widespread in this wilderness area and are referred to as hoodoos. While the top of various hoodoos might look like they are distinct boulders, this is not the case. Instead, the white thin-stalked sandstones are part of the Fruitland Formation, which are quite easily eroded and brittle, as the fine sand particles which compose them were sourced from mudstone and shales. The younger rocks on top form several million years later and represent a portion of the Kirtland Formation, where sandstone much more resistant to erosion formed from the remnants of harder source rock. Thus, over millions of years, preferential erosion by wind and water carved away at the top layer before exposing the more erosion-prone white layer. This layer was then cut into at a faster rate than the layer above it, forming unusually-looking hoodoos. This process is also why fossilized wood that became largely replaced with silicon dioxide acted as a caprock on many of these pillars. The origin of the Bisti Wilderness can be traced back to 75 million years ago when this area was at the very edge of a shallow yet vast inland sea. There were numerous swamps and bogs inland from the coastline which, over time, filled with the remnants of dead plants and would eventually be converted into layers of black coal. Yet, the stable sea level was about to change. While large pterosaurs roamed the skies and plesiosaurs roamed the seas, the global sea level began to slowly decrease, retreating from the coastline. Braided river channels formed and the remnants of pulverized shale and mudstone formed the brittle Fruitland Formation. As the sea continued to retreat, now existing more than 50 miles away, darker colored sandstones with larger sand particles developed, which contained a mostly brown color. After the non-avian dinosaurs went extinct, the Laramide orogeny, a major mountain-building event, happened to be ongoing at a high rate. As portions of the Rocky Mountains were pushed upwards, fine particles eroded from them and were swept downstream, with some of these going on to form the large Ojo Alamo Formation. Over time, these growing mountains to the north and east caused the region to get progressively drier, leading to a change in climate which had less rainfall, meaning rock deposition occurred at a lower rate. During this period is when the Nacimiento Formation formed up until 60 million years ago. Erosion then carved away at these rocks, exposing strange rock formations and numerous dinosaur fossils. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.